But as soon as the header goes down, this thing just steers in random directions. Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to Coldborough Park Farm, where today we are continuing on the work we did last episode by continuing the barley harvest. Let's put the pipe in. We're still in the TF78 because I want the fuel to be somewhat uniform. And while I'm recording this, well, not the same day I recorded the last video, but Monday, the same day we went live, it looks like people are going to want me to keep the legacy on. So I might as well get as much use out of this while I can. Know that you're not maybe the biggest fans of this, but I do like using only the one harvester on a field where I can. I know I've used two on this one so far, but the legacy on is so much bigger than this that it would be a bit silly. I'm kind of surprised nobody said to try out the New Holland pack, the New Holland harvesters, because they are quite nice. They're very nice harvesters, actually. They're seriously high quality. I guess it's because everybody likes the Lexions, I guess. It's the one of the bigger brands in harvesters. Now, I'm also surprised nobody asked me to get a deer. That's something that genuinely surprised me. I think I scared away all the deer fans. Or something. I don't know, but there was surprisingly few requests to get the deer. As you can see, I've got Trackat on again. Because I do think Trackat is best when you're harvesting. Because you can look at the exact spot you want to. We should hopefully get this field done this episode. I don't think we will, but you know, yeah, well, I guess I can't make a solid prediction right now. I'd like to. I don't think we will, though. And this field will be finished with the 78, just because the Lexane is such a bigger header. And I'll be using the Acanola over there. I sent Simulate the last thumbnail, and he said, "Is that a course play I see behind you?" I said, "No, that's just a Lexion parked in the field." Because it was in the background of the last thumbnail. And I will say that I am very, very glad that not many people are voting for the TC59. Turns out it was the TC59 all along. I don't know where I got the TC55 out of. I pulled that out of nowhere and ran with it. Oh god, hot tea. Delicious hot tea, but hot. T. So 57% full. Let's spin this around. We're making, tried to look through the harvester there. We're making good inroads into the field. I mean, this harvester isn't the easiest to drive, or whatever. I'm gonna say that right now. The steering is a bit weird and bad. Could do with some work. And I know somebody said I should edit this thing. I already have as much as I'm going to. I made the grain tank suit the TF78. I think it's the TF78 extra specs. Which is the newest version of the TF78, which, considering this is a computer and all that good stuff, I'm going to presume this is the... I'm going to just run under the assumption this is the newest version. I'm probably wrong. I'm going to be honest, I'm probably wrong. But it's got the biggest grain tank, so that's what I added it to. That's why the grain tank is now 9,500 litres, as opposed to 6,500. Or 9,500 litres as opposed to 6,500. Or 9,500 as opposed to 6,500. Depending on what terminology you like to use for your numbers. So let's get the pipe out, hopefully. It's up to the harvester and get the pipe out. There we we go. We'll grab the T6040. Just bring it over here. Now, I will eventually be swapping carvers other than this map. Spoiler alert, it's not going to be always the Lexion. Because, I always think it's boring when somebody gets a harvester on a map, or even when I do it, when you get a harvester on a map and you just run with it for the entire duration of the map. It's not particularly fun or entertaining. So that's what I'm going to do. I feel a bit like George Saunders at the moment, just carting and talking. I need a GoPro like in front of my face so I could superimpose it in here or something. Or like a superimposed shoulder just there. Tricat seems to be a bit weird today. It's not... it's seemingly drifting. Which is, I'm guessing, something to do with me having moved stuff. So just waiting for the harvester to empty now. It's 20%. How's it looking in the trailer? Pull forward a small bit just so that it's not causing issues. There we go, that's full. Let's bring it around and up to the yard. So the reason I'm using the Marston trailer as opposed to the Marshall is pretty much because I can fit more chaff into it. Or more grain into it even. I could use the Marshall, but it'd be full pretty much one run every time. This is significantly bigger, and it's probably going to be the next trailer I buy. I'll then buy some hardpoint stuff for it, and get it all good there. I'm not sitting quite right, which is irritating me. I'm not 100% comfortable. I think it's my my chair is at a wonky angle compared to the rest of me, so I might move it real quick in a second while I'm unloading this. Come on. That's actually significantly... that's much better. So that's that gone. Get this back into the field. Making... good progress. I wouldn't say ideal progress, but definitely good progress. Almost went into the wrong field. So we'll just leave the tractor trailer here, grab this thing, raise up the header so it doesn't get damaged. Probably should have done that before I started unloading, but oh well. And just get this lined up relatively nicely for our next pass. I know that in reality most of the time you would go for completely straight lines, but this harvester is a bit weird at times. Steering wheel is pretty much one-to-one with what I've got, so you can see the inputs that I'm having to put in to get it to move. Even a small bit, it requires quite exaggerated steering, which I don't think is quite the way that it's supposed to be. Now that said, I am doing my best to keep it in a mostly straight line. It is not a good harvester, I've got to be honest. I'm going to be, when I bring it back to the shop, return it from this rental period, it's going to be leaving my mod folder, I'm going to be honest. It's a shame. I do like this harvester. It's a bad mod. I think a bit more work. No, it needs a lot of work done to it. If it needed a bit of work, I would try and fix it, but I think it's beyond my comprehension. I am dropping straw, right? I better be dropping straw here. I I am good. So we are going to bale up all of the crop fields. Just because we can, pretty much. And what we'll be doing with that then is... we'll take... I don't know how much straw we're going to need, so we'll take probably 2 or 3 loads up to Yatton Ridge. And then just sell the rest. Because there is a dairy farm down the road, they always need more straw. Which is lovely, they've got no issue buying off me, even at a slightly unfair price to them. But they're so desperate they don't notice the difference. they actually offer me a premium, because apparently the straw my crops produce are better or something? I don't know quite why. Now I have heard there's a lawn care firm going to be coming into the area in the near future. They may have already been, actually. I've heard one of the houses up near Yatton Ridge needs mowing, and I don't have really the lawn care equipment required to do that, but I don't know, I might try and get a bit of lawn care done in the future, buy some equipment for that. I mean, how hard can it be? All I need is a push mower, a ride on a strimmer or weed whacker for you Americans, or weed eater for you Americans who don't say weed whacker, because differences in local language. Dialect, that's the word. Differences in dialect. It's like the soda and pop conundrum. Or the, I think over here it's like pop, minerals, and fizzy drink. And just plain Coke, I guess. A lot of people just call any fizzy drink Coke. I don't know why, but they do. I'm sure the Coca-Cola company will not complain. Yeah. So, I am actually drinking a cup of tea, by the way. Nothing wrong with that. I think we are going to actually get this field finished in this episode. So let's get this turned around. The wheel lock in this leaves a lot to be desired, and it's primarily an issue with the rear suspension, I think. Sort of 80% full. I can drive down this row with the harvester on. We can grab the trailer whenever we do get full. I'm genuinely annoyed that this harvester is a bit bad, because I would love to use this, if not here, on a different map. Because I do like me... harvesters that are small enough to be small, but big enough to be big at the same time. You know, it's a harvester that'll fit most farms. Especially if there is contracting going on. And I kind of think New Holland missed the beat by not including this in Farm Sim 15, but I understand why. Because this came out of production in like 2003, I think, or 2006. So let's hop into our T6040. We're making pretty good progress around the field, I think. It's going to be fun to bale. Of all the TF78 related madness going on with the rear suspension. We should be good to get that there. Lovely. Wonderful, 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 wonderful. So, does that say danger overhead cables?
Yeah.
Where? Danger overhead kit. I'm guessing it's for tipping, because I don't see any overhead cables. Just a thought there. It's probably not actually intended for general warnings. I do like how this works though, because you can see the augers and all working in the harvester. Let's just turn the harvester back on, get into forward gear, and away we go. That away. So like that, raise it up. Just wait here for a minute to leave the straw finish depositing. And now we get to wrestle with the wheel again to get this thing turned around. Header down and away we go. Gonna pick up as much of this as I possibly can and smooth this corner off as much as I possibly can. That should be good for future passes. Well, the future pass. I think I'm only gonna get one more pass up there. And if we're lucky, we'll be able to return the 78 now and hop into the Lexion by the end of the video. Which, I'm genuinely surprised. I wasn't expecting to do this well today. I'm now concerned that something's gone horribly wrong and I haven't noticed yet. What's gone wrong? Let me know in the comments. I know I'll probably cop it in editing, but what have I done wrong? What have I screwed up? What am I doing wrong here? Other than not going in perfectly straight lines. Not going in perfectly straight lines was a conscious decision because this thing can't make them. Right, that should be long enough for the straw to deposit. And it was. So, this should be probably two or three passes left, I think. But yeah, the not going in straight lines was a conscious decision because this thing, like, I'm turning 90 degrees at the moment. And it's just, I'm just trying to counteract what the harvester itself is trying to do. Which is seemingly turn to the right, or to the left even, because I'm having to steer quite, actually really heavily to the right. Yeah, something's... I'm glad that I've got this on... I'm glad that I've only borrowed this. On, kind of on demo. I know it's a paid demo, but still. Because, I mean... This doesn't work. Doesn't work for me. Doesn't work for itself, effectively. It's just not good. I'm also glad the other one was on demo. It was so bad that I had to return it almost immediately. I know that's going to cause a bit of a mess, but that'll have to do. Did it cause a mess at all? Eh, a teeny little bit. But as soon as the header goes down, this thing just steers in random directions. Which is decidedly not ideal. It does take a really rather nice swath out of the crop, but it's not what I'm looking for in terms of a harvester. Also, in terms of the game, the front animations are running at 15 frames a second. At most 15 frames a second. Yeah, that's not very good, is it? I mean, you can see the... You can actually see the animation hitching. So I don't think it's actually doing a full animation. I think it's doing half an animation, then hitching back. So we'll just leave that drop for a second. Now turn around. Just grab this bit of straw while I'm... Or a bit of barley while I'm at it. There we go. So this has actually been a very productive video. I didn't think we'd get this field finished today. I didn't think this was a like two video field. Honestly didn't. I know that it's harvesting again and I should be doing different things, but at the same time, I'm not going to apologize for doing the work that needs to be done on the farm. Because it was either this or do some mowing. And we did mowing a couple of videos ago. Plus, I mean, this is effectively goodbye to the 78, because it's getting gone. It ain't staying here. It's I thought it was good. I was wrong. And it's a real shame, because this is a harvester that I would like to use in Farm Sim if I can find a good mod. And there's the issue. I'm gonna try out some other mods anyway, just to see for if and when I decide to start a new map. It'll probably be Little Town getting replaced, because I'm gonna be moving Coldborough to a more speedier version of Coldborough, shall we say. I'm gonna optimize a few things and fix a few mistakes I made and get GMK back in so that I can actually play the game a lot faster, which means I'll be turning off withering just because of reasons. Hopefully with GMK, that's going to mean we can have actually two harvesters. Because there are a couple of fields that will not take a huge harvester, and a couple of fields that I wouldn't feel right using a small harvester in. That is the TF78's job effectively finished. We have done. Let's hop back to that, turn it off. Pipe out, please. Just go back over to the trailer over here. And now I'm wondering if I should start baling this immediately or just grab the Lexion and finish the canola field. I think I'm going to finish the canola field so that you get a bit more harvest. Well, a bit more harvesting for your harvest. Considering last time we spent a lot of time faffing about trying to sort out harvesters, I think maybe better if I just grab the Lexion and get going down with the just carry on with the canola harvest, my wayward son. I've overdone it with the pipe there. I thought I did. There we go. So just leave that empty out, and as soon as it's emptied we will return this TF78. You can see the suspension on the 6840 is not very happy. 20% of a tank left here. I'm really annoyed because this is a really, like, threatening looking harvester in real life, and it's just terrible in this game. So, let's go over here. Return the vehicle, yep. And return that. They're both apparently dirty. Doesn't matter. So let's get this over into the yard and empty her out. Hopefully we'll have time. We probably won't. I'm probably going to call once we've emptied this. I know it'll be a bit earlier than usual. But I want 30 minutes to be a maximum for now. Just so that it's easier on myself. And yes, I am ow, after hurting myself somehow. I am going kind of back to the uncut stuff. The multiplayer is going to be very, very edited, most likely. Last week's was 2 hours cut down to less than half an hour. I'm not kidding. So 3/4 of the stuff that happened was too boring to actually have in. There we go. And what we'll do is we'll just park this up the entrance to the field with the Lexi and the entrance of field 9 over here. You can see there's not much left to do in this field. Well, there's actually quite a lot left to do in this field in particular. So, am I in the middle of a row here just after abandoning the harvester? Oh, crap and a cracker. I've got a minor crisis on my hands. I'll detach the PTO. Detach that. And two things need to happen right now. I need to put the pipe out, which it doesn't seem to want to do. There we go. I know I'm driving out a cab, but you have to deal with that. I'm going to have to put the pipe out and empty it over here. Very off-putting to have a harvester with no header. Because the header is usually your reference point for how close the trailer is. That'll do. So we'll just empty this out and then we'll have to refuel it, because I don't trust 125 litres to last the rest of this field, I'm going to be honest. That'll be the episode then, that'll be the video. So while I'm doing this, I will say if you enjoy the video, give it a like. Feel free to leave your thoughts about the video below. And especially what I've done wrong in this video, because I'm sure I've done something wrong that it went this well. 100% sure of it. It'll probably be something I've done in editing or something. I've just realized that I've done wrong. I forgot to take a thumbnail. Genius. Genius, Dave. Oh well. I'll just grab one afterwards. It doesn't matter too much. So if you've come this far, please leave a comment saying clouds or Dave is a moron. One of the two. And we'll see if Simulating 5 come this far, because they'll probably be wondering why on earth everybody's commenting Dave is a moron. More importantly, we'll see if I can remember, because I'll probably be very confused when this video goes out. So, I will leave you today by saying I've been Rainbow Dave, you've been watching Farming Simulator 15 on Coldborough Park Farm. Until next time, stay safe, and goodbye.